Hi, gymnasts. Anna Kojak here. I'm your mental toughness coach for all things gymnastics, coming to you today with a very, very, very important topic. That is self-love. So I know this time of year, everyone can, you know, say the word self-love over and over and over and again. You can kind of get sick of hearing it, especially in February when Valentine's Day comes, and February is always this month of self-love. I think it's great that there's so much awareness about self-love, but I don't think it should only be in the January-February season. I think it should be all year long for gymnasts, for everyone, but for gymnasts especially. Here's the reason why. You, as a gymnast, are in a sport where you are constantly being picked apart. You might not even realize it, but you are. So you go to meets and you are on display for a judge to watch your routine and write deduction, deduction, deduction. Obviously your goal is not to get those deductions, but you do, because nobody is perfect, especially not in gymnastics. It is so, so, so difficult to be 100% perfect. And even in those routines, if you were to get a perfect 10, there probably was something there that wasn't fully perfect, right? I'm sure there was a little, you know, leg misplacement or toe out of place or whatever it is. It's so hard to be perfect. It's an illusion. There is no such thing as perfect. But you are constantly being picked apart by judges when you go to meets. And again, you might not realize this, but let's say you go and you have the best routine of your life. Let's say you did a vault and it's the best one you've ever done and you get an 8.6. And you're like, okay, that was my best vault. Like, then what starts to happen is you start to think, oh, well, maybe I'm not good enough. Or what could I have done better? Like, that's my best. That's as good as I can do. And then it starts to deflate you. You start to feel like, oh my gosh, I can never get a better score because I worked as hard as I could and that was my best. And look, I only got an 8.6. So those kinds of things, they happen a lot in gymnastics. You are constantly getting critiqued and judged, even in practice, right? Your coach is there to say, point your toes, keep your legs straight, your arms are bent. Like, they are there to point out the negative almost, but it's, you know, to make you a better gymnast and to make you succeed in gymnastics. But it is hard to hear that criticism all the time. Even if it's constructive criticism, it's still someone telling you something that is wrong and needs to be fixed or needs to be done better. So that is so hard. So that is why self-love is especially important for gymnasts. Because again, you're in this environment where this is a constant for you. And when your self-love goes down, the way you practice gymnastics changes. Because if you don't feel good about yourself, you don't bring your full self to your practice. You don't bring your full self to your meet because you think, well, I can't really do it, or this is the best and it's not good enough. And then you don't try as hard. You don't have as much grit. When things don't go your way, you give up because you're like, well, I guess I can't do this. And so self-love is so important for your self-esteem and for how you bring yourself to gymnastics. That is why I made this self-love challenge. I'm doing a bingo challenge over on Instagram in the stories. If you haven't joined that, you are still welcome to join us. There will be prizes, but I hope you don't do it for the prizes. I hope you do it for the challenge. But if you don't want to participate in the bingo challenge on Instagram, you can still go in my bio, the link, and download a PDF that has 24 different self-love challenges. So you can do them over the next month. You can work through one worksheet a day. And these are all challenges that are meant to build up your self-love and help you grow as a gymnast. So I highly suggest, if you haven't downloaded that PDF, that you go to the link in my bio and you download it and you go through those worksheets. But I really want you to be aware of what you're saying to yourself and if you're beating yourself up when you're in gymnastics and how you feel after those meets where you know, maybe even after a meet where you did get a good score, but again, it's not perfect. You didn't get a perfect 10. So you still might feel like, oh my gosh, like what could I have done better? So I want you to be aware of that feeling and how you are bringing yourself to the gym, because there's such a connection there and it's so important. There are a few ways that you can build up self-love. You can start a journal where every single day you write some things that you love about yourself, which is kind of hard to do for some of us. So if that's too hard, you can start writing down things that you love about gymnastics. You can even go general, write about things that you just are grateful for in your life. So any type of gratitude or appreciation journal is so important, whether it's general or about yourself or specific to gymnastics. It's so important to do that, to give that love, that gratitude, that appreciation, and it will come back to you. The more you give out, the more you will receive, even for yourself. So that's one way you can do it. Another way is you can just write down all your strengths as a gymnast. So start focusing on all those things that you do really well in gymnastics and then read that back to yourself, especially on those days where you're feeling less than your best. Yes, this is a way to build up confidence, but confidence and self-love go hand in hand. So the more confident you are, typically, the more self-love you have. And the more you can build up your self-love, the more you can feel confident. You can go over to Just Hear, their blog. I wrote an article for them. I was a guest blogger. And that's some more ways I had to build up self-love. So definitely go check that out on their website. And I hope you guys do participate in the self-love challenge. But if not, download that packet and have it for yourself. I've spent a lot of time on it and I want you guys to get it. So go to the link in the bio and do that right now. All right, guys, I'll see you soon.